It's a system that uses familiar forms from our collective memory that are modernized and reduced to their most essential expression.
We were concerned with the collective memory, the shapes that we have in our minds together as a public that are familiar, and so they're easy to understand, but we sought to create an abstraction, a minimalization of those forms to make it more contemporary and useful in today's type of architecture.
I would say the process was the inspiration. The CEO of the company came up with a pretty clear idea. He wanted to base the collection on archetypes. So the first question is, what are the archetypes? So there was a lot of analysis and research in terms of identifying what an archetype in illumination is, and a lot of exploring how these archetypes, or which of these archetypes, could be combined together in a single system. If you do something based on archetypes and memory, you have to find the balance not to make it too overly vintage. Or maybe you want to use it and really offer a wide range of finishes that you could use it in all kind of different atmospheres. So this is something I think we have just started to explore. Black, for example, is the color we knew immediately would be the most important for us in terms of design, because it's a sign, like it's a line. So this is the closest one to the concept we had. And then the other colors are more related to environments where you could use it.
For us, the most innovative part of the collection is the use of LEDs. Of course, that allows us to reduce the volume of the actual filaments and create a bulb that is not a bulb. In other cases, the LED technology allows us to eliminate really the filament from the bulb. And so with these pieces, as you can see, we've been playing a lot with translucency and transparency. So you can sometimes look in within the piece and there's nothing there. So it offers a kind of airy, transparent feel.